We responded to a call of a vessel requiring assistance in the Swinomish Channel. And when we arrived on scene, this poor boat was laying hard on its port side. The 80-year-old owners had made a navigation error and perched it on a rock at the edge of the channel, and then thought the tide was coming in and were mistaken. And it just fell over hard on its port side. We proceeded to contract with them for the rescue and the salvage of the boat.
And you took it to the closest haul-out yard, and it was hauled out there, and it had diesel everywhere.
Oh, it was a mess.
Engine oil, and the cushions were everywhere. Everything was laying on its side. All the cupboards were opened up. All the drawers were upside down.
The insurance company determined that the owners were going to take the actual cash value of the policy and go buy another boat. So the boat was left orphaned. And I said to Tricia, I says, look at this piece of wood. You know, this thing's pretty. We could fix it. And she suckered for that.
Yeah. 14 years later, we still have it, but we've done a lot of work to it. We're still fixing it. Needed new wiring and everything.
Yeah. So, and then we commenced, the overhaul, one project at a time, fix this, fix that. So we pulled her into the yard to get the flybridge sides and the galley side rewooded, you know, replace the rotten wood. I didn't have the heart or the skill to tear into it, so I hired a shipwright who just butchered the heck out of it. But everything he cut into, I could fix.
He was after just, the rot, and it kept going, and he kept going.
I didn't have
it
the...
It was okay.
I would have stopped, you know. He kept going where I would have stopped, and that was a good thing because, you know, it wasn't his boat.
Yeah.
So he was going to get all the rot, and we did. We cut right into it, and we replaced an awful lot. The concept of where we were going with this repair was like, let's put it in the shop and deal with the rotten wood.
Mm-hmm.
And then I had a floor guy working with me. It's a pretty good carpenter, and he was just adamant that we resurface the decks. He did a gorgeous job on the decks. They're really special.
So it was in the shop for 15 months, and then we took it outside for 2 months, and we painted the whole outside of the boat.
Yeah, we painted
the hull.
The bulwarks inside and the whole cabin. Got it outside, blocked it out, caulked it, sanded it, sealed it, and gave it a couple of really good coats where we use a roll and tip method, and it looks like it was sprayed. This wasn't a hire a bunch of contractors job. This was make John and Trish happy job.
And to do that, we're very picky, so we did it ourselves, more or less.
We tell folks this is a very lucky boat because old wood boats like this don't always have the best of futures. She's a grand old boat, and it has a special aura to it. It was well built to start with, and
we're the second owners.
No, we're only the second owners.
Yep. So it's, yep. It hasn't.
And she chose us. She came to me. Her name's Beachcomber because that's what I do.
We found her on the beach.
Found her on the beach.